So this was quite a huge amount of army which Porus gathered to encounter Alexander. Now Alexander realized that if his army, particularly his horses, confront the elephants first, there will be chaos and confusion. So he planned his army in such a way that in between there the foot soldiers will be there, but they will be flanked by the cavalry and other and the chariots, so that there won't be any confusion. And what when Porus was waiting for him on the other side, he kept or he tried to deceive Porus by showing that he could be attacking him anytime, but and he kept his army marching to and fro, but he did not attack. When Porus realized that there was no chance of any attack for some time, he naturally was not so cautious, and taking this advantage, Alexander actually attacked the army of Porus and he crossed the Jhelum. On hearing about this, Porus sent his son to confront Alexander first while he was waiting for him on the drier ground. The son went with 2,000 elephants and chariots, but unfortunately he was no match for Alexander's army and Alexander himself. So the brave son had to fall in the war. Along with this son, there were other generals also who were defeated and some of them died. Now, the Greek historians give us a story about this confrontation, and we find that when Alexander entered into the dry grounds, Porus and Alexander had a real fight, and it was also raining heavily. So it was very difficult for the army, particularly the archers of Porus's army, to fight because the bows were going down on the sandy banks of the river. In the meantime, fresh Greek soldiers arrived under Craterus. So the Greek side was very strong, and finally Porus could not stand the strength of Alexander. But Alexander was immensely impressed by the valor of Porus, and he did not want that Porus should die. So when Porus was going back, he sent messengers. First Ambi went, but naturally since Ambi was the enemy of Porus, Porus did not listen to Ambi, and later on Alexander sent another messenger who finally caught hold of Porus, captured him and brought him back to Alexander. And there goes this famous story which we learn from the Greek accounts, that when Alexander asked Porus that how should he be treated, Porus says like a king. So this whole narrations are given only in the Greek accounts. Unfortunately, the Indian accounts are totally silent about this. But what we find is that Alexander was so happy with this victory that he issued a medallion. So we now have a medallion which describes Alexander's victory over Porus and how he was pursuing Porus, and Porus is depicted on with his elephant and Alexander with his horse. Now, after the conquest of the region of Porus, that is the region on the bank of the area on the bank of the Jhelum, Alexander gave away all the areas which he conquered to Porus himself, and Porus was allowed to rule it independently. This gained Alexander the friendship of Porus, and naturally he accompanied Alexander in all his expeditions towards the river Chenab and Beas.